Hello everyone, Rich here, and welcome to our second educational video here on TradingView. If you like the content so far, do not forget to like and follow for me to keep going. And feel free to ask your questions in the comment section below, or if you have any ideas about what would you like me to talk about next. So let's get started. As we do every week, we will choose a pair and we'll do a top-down analysis for this pair, and I'll try to make it as educational, practical, and easy as possible. We'll start with the weekly and daily time frames to know where we stand in the market. Is the market overall bullish? Is it overall bearish? Or is it stuck inside a range? Then after identifying the market structure, we will draw our key rejection, support, and resistance, or even our supply and demand zones. Then we'll zoom into lower time frames like H4, H1, or even M30 time frame and look for potential sell setups around resistance and supply, of course, and buy setups around demand and support as well. So let's get started with a previous example first, and then we will go over the actual price to know where we stand in the market and what we'll be expecting for the next couple of days or even weeks. As you can see from this previous example, price was overall bullish, making higher highs and higher lows. So the bulls were in control and we could draw this trend line. Here we go. So starting from these two swings, we can draw this trend line and we can even make an offset for overall direction. And what we could look for, we could look for buy setups around here, as we already drew this trend line from these two swings. So we could look for buy setups from this swing and this swing on the non-horizontal support retest. And we could look for sell setups around this swing and this swing. That's the power of starting from the weekly time frame, because you know where we stand in the market and you know that you will be looking for buy or sell setups. Let's continue. And as you can see, price was overall bullish as mentioned. However, it was making higher highs and higher lows. However, starting from here, price couldn't push any higher to make a higher high. Instead, the price made a lower high, which is an early alert that a potential reversal might happen. Nothing is confirmed just yet, but we know that the buyers are exhausted and couldn't push any higher than it was pushing previously. So we know that a potential reversal might happen, and the reversal would be confirmed, as I always say, after a momentum candle close or momentum break below the last swing low. So price was making higher lows, right, and higher highs. So higher lows, higher highs, higher low, higher highs. As long as price doesn't break below the last low, what I call the last swing standing, just like war, it's the last swing standing on this trend line. Once it's broken downwards, we don't just sell on the trend line break downwards. We wait for the last swing standing to be broken to consider that the potential reversal might be confirmed. Okay, so starting from here, we know that we are no longer in an uptrend and the momentum is shifted from bullish to bearish. And as you can clearly see, price started from here, started to make lower lows and lower highs, lower lows and lower highs. And as you can see, big impulse moves, small corrective moves. That's a second market structure tip. Let's zoom a little bit. You know that you are in a strong trend where the impulse move are pushing in the direction of the trend. So big impulse, small corrective, big impulse, small corrective. As you can see, very big impulse, like a third wave, and corrective, very big impulse. Starting from here, you can see that the corrective are starting to get stronger. So small corrective, small corrective, small corrective. However, here, as you can see, the corrective are starting to get stronger, which means that a potential reversal might happen, that the sellers aren't in full control for now. They are still in control, but the buyers are starting to get in control, to gain strength. And as you can see, one last impulse downwards, then a very strong corrective moves. As you can see as well, that the candles were very huge. Previously, the candles were very small in size. Let's delete our lines. Moment, I'm still not getting used to TradingView. So as you can see, very small candles in size, very small candles. However, starting from here, we've got big, big candles, which means that the buyers are taking control, are pushing aggressively. However, they are not in full control yet, unless they break, as mentioned, above the last swing high. Let's zoom in. Here we go. Here's our last swing high, right? Lower lows, lower highs. And the momentum will be shifted because you are on a downtrend. If you are in an uptrend, the momentum will be shifted if price breaks below the last swing low. However, if you are in a downtrend, the momentum will be shifted if price breaks above the last swing high, like in this case. Let's delete these ones. We go and delete this one as well, and this one, and this one. Okay, so we are, for now, the buyers aren't in control as they couldn't push higher. By break, we want a momentum candle close, just like this one. We want this to break this structure. However, as you can see, it didn't break above it, and we are now stuck in a range. We know that we are in a range when we don't see a clear movement, like you saw previously. Upward movement, big impulse, small corrective. Downward movement, big impulse, small corrective. And starting from here, we are now, as you can see, stuck inside this giant range since 2015. So let's make it like a range. Here we go. And here as well. So now we know from weekly perspective that A, B, and Z, D, from a long-term perspective, is stuck inside a range. So we know that we'll be looking for buy setups as price approaches the lower range, and for sell setups as price approaches the higher band of the range. Unless we've got a minor supply and demand zones in between, then we'll be looking for minor buy and sell movements while price is trying to reach the upper or the lower. And the momentum will be shifted from a range to bullish or bearish if price breaks aggressively above the upper range. Then we will not buy. Then we will wait. Give me a moment. Here we go. Then we will not buy immediately. We'll wait for a retest, and then we'll be looking for buy setups on a retest. And exactly the opposite in case of a break downward. We'll not sell immediately. We'll wait for a retest and then sell after the retest is done. We'll zoom into lower time frames, of course, and look for laser entries with a good risk to reward ratio. For now, let's stick to our top-down analysis. We know that from weekly time frame, we are stuck inside this range. Now we'll try to draw our support and resistance to add more clues to our setup. As you can see here, we can draw this line around one, here we go, because traders stand 1.05. Okay, so 1.05, and we have another one on 1.1. Here we go. As you can see, price made rejection from support, rejection from support. The stronger the swings, the rejection swings, the stronger the support or resistance level is. As you can see, we've got many, many rejections from it. And you are right, price is going to be sitting around it, so we'll be looking for buy setups on lower time frames. We'll go over this one in a bit. Just let us finish drawing our support and resistance. Here's a quick trick on how to draw support and resistance. You simply draw a random one on your chart and drag and drop it in a way to connect as many swings as possible. As you can see here, here we could draw this one, as we've got this one here as well, 3, even 4. So it's a very, very strong one. Let's make it a round number as usual, because traders tend to think in terms of whole numbers, not odd numbers. 1.13. So it's a 1.13. Here we go. Let's make this one in red and keep this one in orange, and we'll draw one last one in red as a support zone. Or we could even draw this one in red, and we can draw one last one. Here we go. It's a very, very clear, support zone. Let's make it in blue, and we will optimize it to be a round number. And as you can see, it's a very strong psychological level or round number 1. The more the zeros after the dot, the stronger the round number is, as more traders will see it and more traders will act upon it, thus bigger the rejection around this level. That's it for weekly time frame. We know so far that we will be looking for buy setups around this support. If price breaks it downward, then our support would become resistance, and we'll be looking for sell setups around it. Then when price approaches our lower support, we'll be looking for buy setups. And if price rejects our support and trade it higher, we will be looking for sell setups around the upper resistance. That's what we know so far for weekly time frame. Then we'll zoom into daily time frame, and we'll try to put the puzzle together. We'll try to see if we can gather more clues. Just like a detective, as I said last time, trading is reactive and not predictive. We don't predict, we just gather clues and come up with conclusions about where the price might go next. As you can see from a daily perspective, we were in an uptrend, price was making minor higher highs and higher lows, then the previous swing low was broken downward. So we are currently in a downtrend, making clean higher highs, lower lows and lower highs, because we are in a downtrend. So as you can see, big impulse. So we are clearly still in a downtrend. It's not a good time to buy. We'll be looking for sell setups, right? And a downtrend, we'll be looking for sell setups. And we could even draw this channel. Here we go. And it's forming like a wedge pattern. So from daily time frame, we know that price is overall bearish, trading inside this this channel. And let's make it a little bit to touch the candle. Here we go. And we know as well that we've got a minor supply area around here. Price made aggressive movement downward from it. Minor supply area around here. Yes, you're right, we've got a demand zone and a demand zone around here as well. So for now, we've got a minor supply area. So we know from daily time frame, from a medium term perspective, that price can reject the upper green trend line and this gray supply area. So let's put it all together. Price is overall bearish, however it's sitting around our lower green trend line, which acts what I call it an oversold area. So we can expect a movement upward, especially after price almost finished its impulse. We don't know yet, but we know that price previously made an impulse, just like the distance of this one, the size of this one. So we may expect a retest till around our upper green trend line. So that's our first clue, our oversold area or our lower non-horizontal support. And we've got this one from weekly time frame by sitting around support. That's why we're also looking for buy setups. So for now, we're looking for buy. When price approaches our upper green trend line, we'll be looking for sell setups. And price from a long-term perspective, we also have a potential setup, we'll be waiting for a third swing because this trend line is not valid yet. It's still an idea, right? Because it's connecting only two swings. For the trend line to be valid, it has to connect at least three swings. So we're waiting for a third swing to form around our green trend line to consider it valid, and then we'll enter buy after a momentum candle close above it. This one is from long-term perspective. It's not my trading style, but for those who like to hold their trades for like a couple of months or even years, I don't know, because it's from daily and weekly time frames. So as mentioned before, for now, we know that price is currently sitting around a support area, and we could even draw this resistance in blue. Here we go. But let's not focus on levels far away from price for now. Let's focus on the price, on the exact price. So for now, we'll be looking for buy setups. Let's zoom into our time frames. For example, we can zoom into H1 time frame, and we'll be looking for laser entries for buy setups on Euro NZD as it's sitting around support. And as I always say, we'll be looking for buy setups. We'll not buy just on support, as price can always break it downward, and as mentioned from weekly, can trade lower. And moreover, because our support and resistance are zones on our chart and not laser lines, so price can still go down a little bit to get more liquidity, kick early buyers out before going upward. So we treat our support and resistance as zones and not laser lines. Unless price breaks it downward aggressively, then our support would become resistance and we'll be looking for sell setups on three tests. We want the break to be aggressive. So for now, price is sitting around support, we'll be looking for buy setups, and we also have this green trend line. So we could draw this trend line. It's not valid yet, yes, we know, but it's still an idea, and we are preparing for a buy setup. We are looking for buy setups. And it's also trading inside this one, forming like a channel. So that's our first idea. We'll be waiting for a third swing to form around it to consider it valid, and then we'll enter buy after a momentum candle close above this area. When the buy is activated, our stop loss would be just below the last swing high, right? Because price is now supposed to make, because we are now in an uptrend after breaking above the last high, price now is supposed to start making higher highs and higher lows, right? If price goes down and made a lower low, right? So the downtrend will resume, and it's not a good idea to keep holding our buy. So that's why we put our stop loss just below the last swing low when the buy is activated, and we target a 2-to-1 risk to reward ratio. And as mentioned from daily, as price approaches our upper green trend line, which acts as a non-horizontal key rejection resistance, we'll be looking for sell setups. That's our first idea, and I don't know if you see it, but I can see that we have a head and shoulders pattern forming. It's not valid yet. It's also still an idea. Here's our head, left shoulder, and here's our right shoulder. Right, it's still forming, and the neckline should be covering the entire head and shoulder structure. So here would be our neckline starting from the start of the left swing. So we're waiting for this one, or if price breaks our trend line, or if price breaks our trend line upward before forming a third swing, then we will delete our trend line. It's not valid yet. It's not valid anymore. And we'll be waiting for the second scenario, which would be after a momentum candle close above the neckline, which I personally prefer this one, as it would be with a better risk to reward ratio. As for this one, our entry would be here and our stop loss would be a little bit bigger. So I'd be waiting for this one, but if, as mentioned before, if price breaks upward, then will be no longer valid. I still have 25 seconds. TradingView is not allowing me to continue, but that's it. I'm glad that we've done. I'll see you on the next one. Okay.